What is up, fellas? JPS Delivers here. Madden 2009, Madden NFL 09, fantasy franchise. Did the first game at the CPU with the Jets. Not a good start off to that franchise, and tell you what, five picks by Jason Campbell, a.k.a. myself, since I'm controlling him. But we have a rivalry matchup, sort of a rivalry, I'd have to say, even though it hasn't been too much of a competition lately, especially since RG3's rookie season. And since he's left town, basically, Redskins haven't been much of shit, to be quite honest with y'all. But this is a pretty solid team. Linebacking crew just all up in the 90s. They got McKelvin out of Troy, first-round pick. Definitely not a first-round pick, though, for the fantasy franchise. But they have a pretty good secondary, a really stellar run defense, you know, with the likes of Holly and Tomahawley and Mr. Patrick Kearney. I don't know why this team is hogging up all the kickers, but I'll let them use any bit of their salary cap on that. It's whatever. But looking at, you know, this offense, our stats, you know, we're 3-1. They're 4-1. They've won 4 in a row. Chad Pennington's their quarterback. Their defense, though, seems to be the one weak link for this team, even though they're 4-1. So their offense has to have been playing exceptionally well. Fred Taylor at running back. Dude has to be running all over people. I mean, fifth best rushing attack. They're 4-1 with a defense that's in the bottom fucking 10 in the league. But fortunately enough, it's, well, I'm not going to say Rashard Mendenhall to start it off, because he has not had a good start to his sophomore year being the starting running back. I don't know what we're going to have to do. I mean, maybe incorporate Ray Rice into this more often. But even then, I mean, both these dudes, I mean, it seems like, and unfortunately, a sack right there. Vince Young is definitely the star on this team to back up on, to rely on. And, I mean, we're going to need to get a lot done with him right there. Should have started scrambling. Started noticing that later on in the game. So, hopefully it looked out better for that since changing that in that game. But here we go. Chris Hope. I tried to get an interception with him on the previous couple of plays. But in that, but this is the difference with Vince Young and, like, a Michael Vick, man. That should be a sack any day of the week. Look at that dude fucking walk off. Like, he's like, yeah, I didn't technically make a touchdown, and didn't make a touchdown on that. I fucked up with Dante Hall. The dude's a speedster. I should have caught underneath that. I took a bad angle into the corner. He took a beautiful route, and when I controlled him, a bad angle. David Harris, the beast of this defense. Albert Hainsworth is rated the best. Him and Vernus Golston, just amazing on their defensive line. Our defensive line. But right here, Chris Henry, get better hands, bro. Come on, man. Come on. Rest in peace to Chris Henry, but we got to do better than that. But here we go, Vince Young trying to set up. But nope, I don't know. Again, a stellar play that it was more so just, you know, it's just like a golfer get, you know, having a saving himself from a hazard, saving him or herself from a hazard. You know, you hit a shitty shot into the sand, and then you put it within, you know, 5 feet of the hole off the sand trap. This should have been a pick six if you ask me, but for some fucking reason, Dustin Keller now has amazing hands. In his sophomore season, we're looking for a breakout on that. But just like a golfer making up for his or her previous mistake. Nice catch right there by Dustin Keller. This passing attack, even though we have a superbly, you know, solid quarterback, you know, running the ball, it's this passing attack, including a deep pass to Roy Williams. That's the UT connection right there. Believe Vince Young was a true freshman when Roy Williams was dominating college football. I think it was NCAA 2004. The video game you can play with him as, like, one of the better players. Like him, Kellen Winslow, Sean Taylor. Like, some of the best rated players in that game. I think Rex Grossman was, like, the highest rated, like, quarterback in 03, maybe? 2003, but 2004, though. I don't know if I'm correct on that. But here we go. Lucky play. I think the interception only happened right there because I was controlling Lawson. Not that I caught the ball or meant to catch the ball with Lawson, but I think it was giving the benefit of the doubt because of that. But here we go. Rashard Mendenhall. The carrying needs, I mean, I improved his carrying. I thought for a second Antonio Pierce was about to take it to the house. But there you go. Vernon Golston, one of the best DNs in football right now for this team. Albert Hainsworth at D-tackle. We got Nick Harvey out of Florida on the other side of the ball. This team is looking sick on defense, and I mean, there's not really much having in the running game And that's why I think this defense has played really, really well so far. But here you go. Trying to set my feet up. Finally do. There's a couple passes that I feel like in this game would have been completed, thrown better, had I set up Vince Young's feet for the toss. But here we go. Flea flicker on this one. Fortunately enough, though, called a hot route so that way Dante Hall could have a little bit of a stretch on the field. But here we go. Vince Young just going to throw this one away. Again, I mean, I know I threw a great deal of interceptions, and that seems to be the case with a lot of these quarterbacks, especially the ones with the smaller quarterback vision bar, which, funny enough, I think the quarterback with the biggest vision bar out of any of the quarterbacks for the fantasy franchises is Rex Grossman with the Madden 2008 computer team, which is starting to look pretty good. Sidney Rice was looking good in that game against the Colts, Donovan McNabb, and then the secondary is looking... I mean, the secondary is rated really well. Griffin brothers. So again, this team is full of some of the best players in UT history, and considering University of Texas is one of the best programs of all time in college football, it's pretty nice to have a couple of those players like that. I mean, the Griffin brothers were the absolute shit when you were thinking about NFL players from Texas in secondary positions, cornerback, safeties. Michael Huff's in there too. I mean, just how good that team was with Vince Young, Michael Huff, the Griffin brothers. And, I mean, that doesn't even mention the offensive line they had, which I don't think too many of those guys ended up with amazing NFL careers. I'm thinking about it, and here we go, fucking select the play. Jesus Christ, the editing on this. The editing is fucking god-awful, fellas. It's god-awful. But, hey, fortunately enough, we got ourselves a nice little bit with this Eagles team. I mean, I'm looking forward to this. I mean, by all means, this Eagles team, as I talk about the secondary and whatnot, I lost my train of thought. Jesus Christ. And also, Jesus Christ at that. So this game, settling for quite a bit of field goals, if you ask me. I'm, you know, and also, too, y'all watching, I'm sure you've noticed already. But this offense is getting a shit ton of yards. It just doesn't seem to be panning out all too well, even though Roy Williams is panning out very well. This is, I mean, at this point, Roy Williams is actually starting to kind of decline in his career because, you know, at this point, like, reaching just the ultimate being like 94, 95 in Madden. And then, you know, when you're drafted by the Detroit Lions, shit happens. And, yeah, that's what happened here with Roy Williams. But, you know, Vince Young, Roy Williams, this is turning out to be an excellent duo right here. And if we can get a third wide receiver, this should have been a touchdown right here. I know, spoiled the next 3 seconds of that clip right there, but should have been a touchdown again. I feel like 14 points are left off the board just by inaccurate passes. By, well, not 14 points left off the board, but technically like 8 points if you're going to count the 4 extra you'd get from an extra point. God forbid it gets missed or blocked. But this isn't NCAA 2008. That's not happening. But, again, this defense giving up a decent amount of passes. Chad Pennington, again, you know, it's not Chad. You're not dealing with Chad Pennington of, like, Madden 2004, Madden 2005. You know, like a 90 overall or something. But there you go. Bowden, whatever the fuck you want to say it. All I know is that Bowden is Bowden well for this team. Nice catch by Roy Williams. The dude has a hell of a game. You're already seeing it. And he's not done yet on his highlights. And speaking of highlights, nice little run right there by Rashard Mendenhall, but I believe it was actually a holding penalty. I cut it off early. But in essence, though, this team is looking pretty stellar. I don't know how I pulled that off right there. Again, I think that's the thing, that sometimes I pull it off to where I'll back it up and then use my offense alignment out, just out in the middle and whatnot. But here we go with NCAA 2008. It's an awesome game for the highlights and stuff, and this is a little, you know, I'm going to start not pressing X. You know how, like, when you're playing a video game, you just constantly, like, pressing X? I feel like people jam it too much because it kind of takes away some cool effects of the games because I haven't noticed something like this in a while. I was like, holy shit, this was in the game. So you have highlights like that. I'm going to start by stopping pressing X on that one because, I mean, pretty cool effect. I know NCAA 08. Has pretty much the coolest effects when it comes to nice catch right there by Roy. But I mean, dude has like what, 10 catches in this game for crying out loud? Dude was beasting and feasting. But here we go, Vince Young again. It's just making plays, just batted down right there. Probably should have been attempted to be picked off, But, I mean, it is what it is. It is what it is. Again, leaving points on the board, making it down the field. I mean, getting like 150 extra yards of offense compared to this Redskins team already. But here we go. Pass out. That was a lazy attempt by Mr. I think it was Michael Griffin because Cedric, I'm pretty sure Cedric Griffin was the cornerback. Michael Griffin was the safety. But then another play by Griffin given up. And, well, this team's going to be marching down the field. Fred Taylor pulls off a nice run finally. Felt like we bottled him up pretty well for the most part. But overall, though, I mean, hey, this team has played a pretty good game on defense. I know they get the first down right there on the fourth down conversion. But it's time for a goal line stand, man, as he gets down to nearly the half-yard line. And then Chad Pennington decides to pull off some of this shit. Doesn't work. Fourth and goal now. This is one of the closest plays. I would have challenged that, in all honesty. But it is what it is. Gets stopped up on the first two plays, and then easily the highlight of the game is this catch right here. I mean, it's nice when you time that well off the catch, and you just straight up fucking just take off. And right there, it looked really, really nice. Roy Williams easily. I mean, I thought he almost like around 200 yards, but now Vince Young with two touchdown passes. Most importantly, zero interceptions and has over 300 yards on the day, and I'm pretty sure he's a leading rusher as well. Even taking negative 2 yards and add that, make that a negative 5 yards total, negative four, negative 5 yards total for the game because he did two quarterback kneels at the end of the game. Don't want to get anybody hurt. This defense is doing well. Gave up a couple big plays. When you're playing a better team, felt like this Redskins team was completely, blown out. Of the water, just not only in the game, but I just feel like 4-1, this team is not a 4-1 team. I'll be surprised if the Redskins get a spot in the playoffs. I really don't anticipate that whatsoever. But yeah, whatever. I mean, this Eagles team's looking stellar. Vince Young with over 60 yards rushing. And there you go. Yeah, it was 213 yards. It was only 6 catches. It seemed like way more. Chris Henry with 42 yards. Dustin Keller with a couple of those short receptions that he made into, better plays. Pretty sure he probably had 25 of those 35 yards being runs after the catch. But it is what it is. It is what it is. Dustin Keller with an impressive game and whatnot. So looking forward to this team. Shitting on the Redskins here. This Eagles squad looks really good, really tough. And the offense, let's get Vince Young a fucking MVP. As always, fellas, take it easy and see y'all next video.